Greetings, fellow YouTubers. How you doing? Irv Lindsay here. Today, we're gonna take apart, or try to take apart, a Generation 1 1985 Hasbro Transformers Type A Optimus Prime. Hopefully that makes sense. All of those bits and pieces of that description make a difference. It's not a reproduction. This is actually a really old original 1985 Hasbro Optimus. So let's get to it. And you can see he's in, especially right there, it's got most of the paint intact on it. It's in really good condition. I picked this up off of eBay for about 20 bucks, guys. So I'm real fortunate. It's just missing this one piece here. I am not an expert in this. I know just enough to be dangerous, all right? So together we'll explore and we'll see how to disassemble this. The first thing I'm gonna do is put his wheels down, put his arms back, get them out of the way. And as you know, the head flips back. Make sure I'm on camera here. The head flips back and this comes open. There's two screws right inside here. A lot of people like to keep the fists there if you're fortunate enough to have those. I am not. Once you get those loose that you just saw me unscrew, the whole top piece comes off, all right? All right, so you will need another regular screwdriver. This one's really long, but it's what I have in the house. There is a clip that comes off of that when you unscrew the screw. And just remember that this is a slightly larger screw than some of the others. And what you want to do is you want to swing the top upwards and it just kind of pulls off. All right. You see it has those two little pins in the middle. I'll take these tires off. Tires come off pretty easily. You just kind of pull at it with your finger and just kind of comes off. I was looking online at a way to take this lower piece apart. Evidently you can't. Not without possibly doing some very serious damage to it. So for now I'm just stuck with this broken bumper. And you know what? I'm happy with that. That doesn't bother me. I do think I could probably replace it by breaking it. But that's risky and I don't want to mess with that until I have another bumper to replace it with. So for now, I'm just going to go ahead and complete what disassembly I can safely. The windshield does come out. There's a couple of clips on the side. And if you hold it like this and press with one of your fingers, get your screwdriver and press the side rear window, you'll release that clip on that side. You'll hear it. It'll just kind of pop loose. You know, the same thing on the other side, and the window just comes out. So we can clean this. This is really yellowed. See how yellow it is? You can really tell it's really yellow. There's a number of ways discussed online to get these bottom legs loose at the hips. All of them involve really complex things that me and my lack of training and my amateur skills do not want to risk. I just got this leg off, which means, hey, I just learned how to do it. So now I'm going to show you how I did it on this other leg. Now on this leg I had a sticker. I was able to get this off without messing the sticker up, which, you know, I still might have to remove the sticker and that's okay. It's kind of old. Alright, so you've got three screws on this leg here. One, two, three. First one you're going to take off is this one here at the knee. Once you get that screw loose, you're going to take the fuel thing off, the fuel tank. Toss it in your pile, and then this will just kind of slide off of here carefully. Alright. There it is. Now I have a complete lower section of Optimus. If you can find one of these like this, then you can just replace this, and there you'll have, that's the only way really to replace the grill. Now if you look on here, you see there's a pin, like a little tiny nail, right in the center of that tire and that rim. You gotta remove that pin on both sides and then everything else evidently just slides apart. But that doesn't happen easily.
And I haven't found anybody to tell me how to do this, so for now, I'm just going to leave him the way he is. And you can see that chrome is in really good condition. This is an excellent piece. Somebody took really good care of this. All right, now let's take apart the rest of this leg here. Once you get that second screw loose, this piece comes off. Okay? And then this foot comes off. That still has the tires on it. This piece is actually metal, whereas these pieces are plastic. The foot, is like, just like the front of the cab, this foot is actually made of metal. Now you can remove these tires. The tires just kind of peel off if you kind of pick at them. Just be a little careful. Alright, it just comes right off. You see those two pins on there? Now this, you could actually knock those pins loose from behind. Unfortunately, we can't do that with the torso and the front tires. So if you wanted to actually take these two off of here, if you were adventurous enough, you could do that. I am not. I'm going to disassemble the top a little more. I'm going to go ahead and there's a screw on each side right here and right here on the other side that I'm going to take apart. There's another screw in the back right there. It's right underneath his head on his back. Alright, I got all the screws loose, and if you just kind of work this back and forth carefully, it will pop loose. But it has a little pin right here, has a couple of pins there. They friction fit inside of that piece there, and it holds together really well. But it does come apart. Once you do that, you can swing the arm back around and just pull it out. It just literally comes loose. This comes right on out. I'm going to leave the remainder of the arm alone because if you take a good close look, you'll see there's a spring in there. I'm afraid of what will happen if I unscrew this screw and try to take this apart. I'm not sure that I get it go back together with that spring going and bouncing off the other side of the room. So I don't see any reason to take this arm apart. So I think I'm just going to leave it intact. But I am going to take this top piece off. Okay, you're going to pull this back piece just straight up and off. And it looks like the two screws and that stack piece are going to try and come with it. Drop those screws out. They look to be just a little smaller than the other screws you've been taking out, so take note of that. Alright, so your four smallest screws are for the arms. I've zoomed in a little bit. I want you guys to see, over the years, this has worn quite heavily. One of the things that happens when it wears is it accumulates this dust. And I don't know if it's from the plastic wearing or just dust getting into it in general. But when you clean this, it'll remove some of the dust. It will make this a little easier to turn, alright? Now, it's okay if these pieces fall out. You're going to take them out in a second and clean them. But there's two pieces, alright? There is an inside piece to this hinge and an outside piece. Here is the outside piece, and it just barely goes, you'll see this little curl, right, this little half circle here, and it goes back inside there, and it fits perfectly into this other little piece. They fit together, they both have teeth, alright? So take that out, and take that out. Now if this little metal piece falls out, just remember that the bigger part of this metal piece goes at the top up here on the opposite side from this little half circle, okay? And I'm going to just spray this. I'm going to take this smokestack out carefully. Just going to spray the inside of this. Get my toothbrush here. This is a Colgate toothbrush, I believe. It's the one that has the cross-action bristles on it. Yeah, good toothbrush. Love these toothbrushes. Make good cleaning tools, too. Because of the cross-action bristles on them, they scrub really well. So whether you're scrubbing and cleaning out an old Nintendo cart or an old Game Gear cartridge, done it all, man. I've done it all. All right. Now I'm just going to spray it and clean it like this. Then I'm going to put it back together because I don't trust that I'll remember later how this goes. And I recommend you do that same way for both of these pieces. Hold that metal tab in as you clean the outside. Once again, if it falls out, no big deal. Just remember what I said. Basically, you want to be sure and get all that dust out of these grooves and away from, off of this hinge. For this piece, I'll go ahead and spray the whole thing. I do not disassemble this. It's got that spring on there. I have heard horror stories about folks taking this apart and losing that spring because it is under pressure in there. I am moving this little hinge nut up just a little bit and trying to get, once again, getting the bristles. That's why you want to use a brush or something. Get those bristles down in there and clean out any dust that's down inside there, and it'll help this move a little better. Now you can get reproduction sticker sets for these. You can peel these stickers off that some 9-year-old probably put on here poorly and crooked. You can get reproduction stickers and put on here if you like. I kind of like the way this looks. It looks vintage, it looks played with, I'm happy with that. That's not to say that one day I won't get reproduction stickers and put on it or do some other stuff to it. Alright, you can see there's a lot of parts here. Now, it occurred to me that there's a lot of left-right pieces, and you're going to want to kind of keep those straight as you're going. I think I pretty much got mine lined up. There is a left and a right foot, so keep... there's a left and a right leg. How can you tell? Well, you see, the two legs of the trailer will line up like this, and they make this little... Let me put my hand here. That way it'll focus on it. All right, they make this little round bump here. Okay, you see that? So when you put the two inner thighs together, you should form that bump. If you have the two inner thighs like that, that's the wrong way. You've got them inverted. That's how you can tell the right leg piece from the left leg piece. All right. All right. So those would go like this because those are in back. Those are behind him. All right, and the other pieces just fit into place, and I think I've got mine backwards, but that's okay. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to lightly spray these with some alcohol solution. I've got an old toothbrush here that I use for cleaning toys and electronics. You know, there's all sorts of different ways you could do this, but I'm going to clean them off. I'm going to lay them out to dry. And I'm going to put them back together. Once again, I really wish I could have figured out this bumper piece. And I might do a separate video on this for you guys. Because there's a lot of interest in the bumper. The parts you really want to get when cleaning these is up inside these hinges. A lot of dirt and scum tends to collect up in there. And it keeps them from moving smoothly. And so if you can get something like this up in there and just kind of brush all that muck out from in there, these will move very smooth. Oh yeah, that is really smooth. I can really tell a big difference just from doing that. So make sure you clean your moving hinges and that'll get all the 30 years of grime and muck out of there. All right, now if you were smart, unlike me, when you took your legs apart, you would have taken your left leg apart, put all those parts in one spot, and took your other leg apart, put all those parts in one spot.
Unlike me, I did not. I threw them all in the pit. So the good news is it doesn't look like it goes back together wrong. All right. When you put it together, it'll go on the inside. It'll put together.
It'll go together just like that. You see how nicely that went together?
I made the mistake of putting that bottom screw on there. You can't put this back on there with that bottom screw on there. So you want to attach this to the torso before you put that bottom leg screw on, and just kind of fit it on here, and it'll snap into place the way it's supposed to. All right. Once you get that on there, finish tightening this screw. That's what I did. I just kind of put it on there loose. Now you don't want to over tighten these. You don't want to strip anything, break anything. All right. Now remember, in order to finish this, you have to pull that other leg back so you can get to that inner screw for the knee. Before you can screw this back on, here's a mistake I just made. You've got to put the fuel tank on here. You can see this is the fuel tank. You see it has this little piece right here. That piece fits perfectly into the side of the leg. Let me show you. There's a hole there. There's a hole there. Take this. Put it on there, snap it into place, turn it over, and then you can screw your screw in there. All right, please note, I just noticed this when you're taking the tires on and off, that the tires do have little branding letters on one side, like if it were to say, for instance, it doesn't, what does it say on here? It says, Desert Dog. Formula. Desert Dog Formula is what the tire says on it. Alright, the other side does not have any lettering, so obviously the side that says Desert Dog Formula, at least on my Optimus, those are going to go on the outside. As a matter of fact, if you don't put those on the outside, it seemed to me like it didn't want to roll right. These legs move, oh, they move so much more smoothly. I just want to tell you that. It really makes me feel a lot more comfortable in transforming Optimus. You can see it's not loose, it's just smooth. Alright, just click this window back into place. That's pretty easy. Now, once you have this back on there, and guys, I forgot exactly how it went, so be sure you take pictures, take video, whatnot. Two common mistakes when putting this back together, and I almost just made the mistake of not putting my smokestack back in place. So you're going to stick that back in right. Is that where it goes? I think that's where it goes. That goes down here. It goes down here. See that? That's how it goes back together. The other thing, once again, common mistake, is putting your upper arm back in the socket. Don't be so overzealous to get this put back together that you do it wrong. And I'm not even sure I'm doing it right, and even now I'm not sure I'm doing it right. But we're going to put it back together and see what damage I've done. All right, let me show you how easy this is to move now. Look how easy that is to move. It was so stiff before, I was afraid I was going to break it. Yeah, awesome. All right, so you have two pieces here. These are the two pieces. I like to put the arm up like this. See? Now the gray stripes, the silver stripes, tell the tale of how it matches up. What doesn't, you can put this together wrong. You can put this together wrong. All right? You'll notice there's a hinge. Okay, it's a funny looking hinge. And if you notice, one of the hinge pieces sticks out funny. You see that bottom piece right there that's sticking out? It goes like that. So what you're going to do is you're just going to kind of slide this. But once you get it lined up and on there, the inside will look like that. See it? See how that bottom piece is slightly longer? Now you're going to get these two pieces, you're going to put them side by side. See that?
You see where the fists go, where the headlights are? You see that? Now those are going to go side by side, and your seat is going to go in the middle, and they just kind of snap into place. I can't explain it, but once you get it lined up just right, it just kind of goes snap. The arm has to be in place as you click this in. I hope this makes sense. Now, Optimus head goes right in these two places here. Make sure you get him on straight. You might have to pull this back apart a little bit if you pushed it all the way together already. That's fine. Push it back together real tight. Don't break anything. Remember, it's just a cheap piece of formed plastic. Now, the front, your front goes on. Remember what I said when we were taking this apart? These little half circles or notches right there. See that? If you just kind of, it just kind of slides into place. You see it? All right, once you get your cab back on there, you're going to put the whole thing on its face like this, because you've got this that you've got this metal clip you're going to put on the back of your grill bumper piece. And it does help if you just kind of use your screwdriver to kind of stick it in place. And I'm doing it like this for a reason, because this screw will continually drop. If you try to put it down flat the other way, this screw will continually drop down inside your Optimus there. So this seems like a much better solution to me, that I can do this two-handed. Just kind of screw it back on there. Be careful with it. Remember, you're screwing into a cheap piece of plastic through a piece of plastic into another piece of plastic. All right, so this should swing freely. Now, I've got a number of screws left. So make sure you get all your screws back where they go, all right? Extra screws at the end of a job like this is bad. Alrighty, now get your cab piece, swing your arms around and out of the way. That seems to be the best way to do this. Stick it right there on top, and it's just going to drop right on in. Now, I'm going to pull Optimus head kind of up a little bit and out of the way. And then you're just going to drop these screws in and tighten them down. Alright, now on the sides, we have screws that we took off. There's one here. And then there's one on the other side as well. This is so easy to use now, because everything has been cleaned. All the dust has been removed. And it moves so smoothly. It's really nice. It's like having a brand new toy. Now look. Look at how easy it transforms now. The elbows are still a little stiff. That's because I did not take those apart to clean them. There you go, man. Check it out. Alright guys, there is a fully cleaned Optimus. He's really easy to use now. Everything is nice and loose the way it's supposed to be. and it doesn't feel like it's gonna break. It goes back together nicely. You can see I'm not struggling at all. These elbows are still a little stiff because I didn't take those apart because they got those springs in them. And there you go. Real easy to transform, like playing with a brand new toy. Doesn't look like a brand new toy. So that's it. That's how to disassemble and reassemble a Generation 1 1985 Optimus Prime Transformer A. That is the description that was given to me. I don't know everything there is to know about Transformers. But this was pretty easy to take apart. The only problem is if you're trying to get that grill off, that's not something easy to do. Buy a lower half Optimus Prime, just buy his torso, or get a junk Optimus where the top of it has been messed up or something, and just steal that middle torso piece off of it. And really, you can't take the hips apart, you can't really take the grill off. Having said that, you probably could break it and then screw it back on from behind. You would not be able to see the broken pieces from the outside. However, I don't want to do that because it seems wrong to break Optimus. Anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I do all sorts of weird stuff on this channel. It's a variety channel. My main channel page is youtube.com/ErvTV. I'm also on Facebook at facebook.com/ErvLindsay. I'm also on Twitter. I'm also on Instagram. You'll find links in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, everybody. Appreciate it, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your week. Keep fighting the good fight, and I'll see you in the next video.